welcome to Unwritten Stories of Significance. I am so excited. Why? Because Bella and Kyla Thomson returns with their next chapter. And with no further ado, I'd love to welcome Kyla and Bella Thomson. Hi, guys.
Hello.
Hi, how are you?
We're really good.
You're good. Can you hear me?
Yeah. Oh. It was glitching a little bit, but now I think we're okay.
Awesome, honey. So welcome back to Unwritten, sweethearts. It's been a while.
Yes.
Yes, it has. And you look beautiful, Bella. You look adorable, honey. And I know what you've just been finished eating, by the way. I know what you've been...
Oreo.
I know. And how many did you have? Five?
Two.
Well, it seemed like you had more, but that's okay. It's all good, honey. It's all good. But I'm so happy. So talk to us, honey, because we spoke... Oh, when was it, Bella? It's been 2 years?
A while ago? My goodness.
It's been a while, honey. So I know what's been going on and everything through TikTok. But if you want to bring us up to date on the next chapter of your life and Bella and all the inspiration you want to share with our viewers, sweetheart.
I got my bowel transplant.
Yay!
So now I can have popcorn.
Oh, all right, girl.
Less restrictions with the food.
Popcorn soon.
Yes.
Popcorn or what else?
Popcorn is soon.
Soon. Maybe some more like dairy sugar.
But my first ever new food that I got to try was oatmeal.
Now, you know something? I gotta laugh at this, Bella, because sometimes people say, oh, oatmeal, but you're saying oatmeal. Wow.
You like it?
Okay. So are you excited, honey? Are you excited?
Yeah, because at first I can have like oats and nuts.
That's right, honey. That's right.
So now I can.
Oh my God, look at you, oh my God. You know, it's so exciting. When your mom, when Kyla, when you posted it on the internet, on Instagram, and you got the news, and then you were going on the plane and everything, and she's sitting in the bed, honest to God, I was crying inside. It was just like an amazing news. How did you feel, hon, hearing this news?
It was everything for us. I knew at that point that this was her life-saving surgery. She was going to make it through. This was going to help her.
You felt nervous and excited.
Yes, I was nervous and excited. I wasn't worried. I was like, this is what she needs. Everything felt smooth, and it didn't feel scary in any way. It felt like...
It only took 8 hours.
Yeah, her surgery, normally a 10 to 20 hour surgery, was only 8. Her surgeons were very happy with how smooth it went. It went quicker than normal, and she's recovered quicker than the average transplant child.
Wow. Honey, you are a tower of strength, Bella. I will never, ever get mad on my short surgeries, if I said that right. You are a powerhouse, honey. Like, amazing, hon. How do you feel, sweetheart, now that you can have popcorn and oatmeal and awesome?
Yeah.
Awesome, sweetheart. So what have you been doing? Okay, double thumbs.
Yeah. We flew from Saskatchewan to Toronto to have her bowel transplant at SickKids. And we have needed to stay in hospital for quite a few months.
Yes.
When we don't have to sleep at the hospital, we can come to the Ronald McDonald House, which is just a couple blocks away. So we're back and forth quite a bit. Like, she has a lot of clinic appointments at SickKids. So we're there daily at this point. But eventually that'll be weekly, bi-weekly. And then as soon as it's safe enough for her, less blood work is needed, less medications are needed, then we can go back home to Saskatchewan.
That's
so
right.
We've been here 3 months, and thankfully, the Ronald McDonald House here has a school, so Bella's been able to go to school all day on good days.
Awesome, honey. That is amazing, sweetheart. Now, are you missing your daddy and your brother? How's that been?
No, because they're coming tomorrow.
Okay. Awesome. Oh, my God, honey. So you actually get to see them again.
Yes.
For two whole weeks.
Yeah.
They're staying for 2 whole weeks? Wow. Now, I know that you've been busy. And I'm going to get to your mom right now. I'm going to ask, before I show these pictures, I want to ask you something before I forget, Kyla, because I'm really touched about you both being here. With the procedure on how you're working with Bella, has the medical applications, the treatments that you do as a medical mom shortened? Have they gone shorter or smaller for you? Or?
Oh, yes, so much. And I mean, the main one has been the fact that she's no longer surviving off of IV fluids. She now has new bowels that work. And so I don't have to hook her up to IVs anymore. Her ostomy is not draining her body of fluids, so I don't have to hook her up to drainage bags anymore. And her amount of medications have been cut in half. The ones that she does take are tiny pills that she can swallow with a glass of water. It's a world of difference. And I mean, all of that, plus the fact that she's not in so much pain that her old bowels would cause.
Wow, honey. Bella, how do you feel about that, girl? How do you feel?
I feel good.
You feel good, girl, because I remember when you were telling me, hon, on your first interview with me, and we had a blast.
Sorry.
Oh, I'm going to join you on that one, okay? Is that when you said, when you said you had the needle, and I'll keep it short, honey, that it burned. You don't get those needles anymore? You don't get those needles? Oh, phenomenal, sweetheart. So I know you're in Toronto, which I love. I really, really do. You have been going all over the place because you keep up. Kyla, you, even though you're doing your medical mom, you show us everything that you and Bella are doing. So I know that you went to the Raptors game.
Yeah. Yeah, go Raptors. Woo. That was our first NBA game that we've ever been to, and it was the Raptors. Awesome. It was so awesome. It was an atmosphere. And since you mentioned that, so before Bella's bowel transplant, it was scary not knowing how my daughter's future would look when she was surviving off of IVs. And I would take every moment we could when she was feeling good to do something exciting or to give her an experience she hasn't had. Yeah. And I feel like that's still a part of me. It's kind of like, I always want to take her out and do things that we just don't get to experience on the like average day at home in Saskatchewan. You know what I mean?
Yes.
Let alone, you know, trying to fill a bucket list type of life. And, yes. You know, it's funny, my husband and I joke about it when he's here. He's like, we're just happy to be together. He's like, honey, you don't have to plan something every hour.
That's right.
Just be now.
But you know something, hon? That's the mother in us though, right? We just want to plan things for our kids, do things together. But just even sitting down and eating popcorn with your brother, Bella, watching a movie is going to be amazing, honey.
Yes. Yeah.
Yes.
We have lots of movie theater plans.
Yes, honey. Yes. And there's a picture that we have of you and your brother cuddling. We're going to show that to our viewers, which is awesome. Oh, my God. Bella, I'm going to ask you something just for me. All right. What kind of popcorn do you like? Do you like butter or do you like candy kind of popcorn?
I like butter and salt.
You like butter and salt? Now, why butter and salt? That's just your favorite? You just like that?
You like the salt, yeah.
You like the salty stuff. You like the salty stuff.
You are. You do like it, yeah.
That's awesome, hon. So what was school like, Bella? What was school like being down there?
It's good.
It's good, honey. It's good. Do you get tired quite a bit, sweetheart? Yes. All right.
Yeah. Her little body, she's got big energy in a little body. And quite often she is go, go, go like me until her body's like, wait a minute, we need a rest.
Right.
Yeah.
So she'd go to sleep now. Like, what time would you go to bed, Bella? What time, honey?
Usually by 7 or 8.
Eight.
Around 8 o'clock. And do you sleep right through now? Like, how are your sleeps been?
Good.
Really good. She's always been a really good sleeper, no matter what.
Since I was a baby.
Since you were a baby. You started your life in a NICU with bright lights and loud noises and 40 other babies in the same room. So yes. she's always kind of been a real good sleeper, no matter what the scenario, which is good because it's like her body knows with everything else that goes on with the rare disease that she's battled, her body's like, we're going to sleep. I don't care what's happening. We're going to sleep. So that's one thing she's always done really well. And I've been really happy that she, like, when we sleep in the same hospital room together, I'll be up and she's just out like that. She's just like, and like peacefully sleeping. So I'm really happy that she's able to get good sleeps.
Oh, Kyla.
Dad says I'm the same way. My husband says I'm the same way.
Oh.
My head is pillow and I'm out.
Well, how does your hubby feel now, hon? Even though he's not with us, he's here in spirit, but
yeah.
How is it he feels as a dad that his little baby girl doesn't have to deal with that anymore? She has
twins. Dad and I are like twins.
You and Dad are like twins, yeah. Very similar in demeanor and the way they are. Looks
and
blue eyes. Yeah. He's so relieved. Like so many years from when she was born and we were in the hospital consistently for like 2 years straight, you know, he missed out on so much.
Yes.
Not only missed out on that because he had to be home working, taking care of our home and his job, but you know, he was missing his daughter. He was missing when she'd sit up or when she'd roll over, when she'd walk. And he's able to catch up on that now without the worry added, right? Like he can breathe a little bit easier knowing like she's we're not scared and in hospital every day because of pain and bowels that are failing. She's in recovery now and doing amazing, and so it's a little bit easier for him to be at home now too.
That's right. So his heart's at rest in a place.
Yeah.
That's it, honey.
Yeah. And he's got our son with him too, right? So he's got it's boys' night every night.
That's right. Well, I'm going to follow up on this conversation because I know that there was a little TikTok or something that he filmed with him going on the bus for the first time. So,
yeah.
But we'll hold that. We'll hold that. We'll come right back, guys, with Bella and Kyla Thomson. Stay tuned. Welcome back to Unwritten Stories of Significance with Kyla and Bella Thomson. Hi there, guys.
Hi.
You know what I've been saying, guys? I'm going to laugh at this. Kyla, I said Thompson.
Yeah.
And I said to myself, you got to correct this woman, man, because I can't say Thompson. It's Thomson. Oh, my Lord. I apologize.
That's okay.
I apologize.
Our pastor that married us out loud as Tomlinson. So it's okay.
Okay. All right. I don't feel too bad. Bella gone or is she still there?
She's just beside me taking a break.
Yeah. No worries, hon. No worries. Yeah. I want you to share how it's been because I watch your TikToks. I watch them. Oh my God. Honest to God, kind of, it keeps me real. And it keeps me grateful and it keeps me grounded. I got to tell you, right, this from woman to woman, mother to mother. Can you share with our viewers how it's been and how do you get through this? I know it sounds like repeat pizza, but girl, you are something else. You really, really are. So if you can share with the viewers how it's been, hon, and
we'll
leave it. Yeah.
Yeah, I've really always used social media as a tool to let people know outside of the hospital life that we live, which is so secluded. A lot of the time with an immune compromised child, you know, you can't go out in a lot of public places. So it's always been my drive to share the kind of life that some parents live when they have to care for their child with rare disease or in hospital for long hospital stays. And right. I found as I started sharing mostly for my family and friends to understand what we're going through, because it's really unique. Like we're going on year 10 of living in hospital for my daughter's rare conditions and treating them. Right. And we're on the cusp of that, of being away from that. We're very close now that she's had her bowel transplant to just living a life free from hospital, which is amazing. But you know, there's a lot of parents out there that have 1 or 2 years even in hospital, and they know that, or it's a lifelong journey. And yeah. I really wanted to share that because not a lot of that, the average person doesn't understand what it means to live with rare disease, or even the toll it can take on a family or a child being in hospital every day. And I really wanted to support other parents like myself. And I found that everyone really started to notice and really latch on to how Bella is with this life that she has to go through because of her disease, how she's always happy. And she goes through really hard things with ease. And it as a teacher by trade myself, I thought this is a really good learning tool. But also, we really just want to help other kids get through really hard things. Yes. You know, and I think showing them a young child, my daughter, who is brave through a lot of real hard things, sharing that happiness, joy, and having them understand, look, we're still going through hard stuff, and you can brave through things. And find the joy on the other side, and difficult times will happen. And we just want to be a beacon of hope and help for people with similar scenarios. And I just really social media, and I really hope that's the case. And TikTok is primarily, we are about funnies on TikTok. We like to make TikTok funnies with a splash of updates. Yes. Instagram is a little bit more, personal and more of like a diary or a blog or a vlog. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Just letting you know, we had a little bit of technical difficulty there, and it's all part of that wonderful world of the internet. So Kyla, that was amazing, hon. That was truly, because you, as I've always said in my first interview with you, hon, is that, and then your podcast you did with me, is that you are a power of strength. Your messages through Instagram are powerful. Your TikTok, hello. Like the stories, you keep the humor, and then you keep the reality, the actual reality to it. And why is that? Why is that?
Yeah, so I've always wanted our socials to be primarily a safe space for little ones and their families, whether they're going through it in hospital or hard, difficult times outside of hospital. I want it to be a space where they know they can come there and not feel scared, but feel joy or feel encouraged or learn how to be brave by seeing my daughter's medical journey and our medical journey and my family. And I always want to share with everyone and let them know, like, we are real, like we go through it. There's some real hard times, and there's just so much that you just can't share online, but it doesn't mean it's not there. You know, there are some really hard things. I just don't share those in detail because I don't want to scare other little kiddos. I don't want to worry them or stress them out. So we acknowledge that those hard days are there. But we try to share in a positive light and in a brave light as much as we can.
Well, I got to tell you, there's a couple of young people that I know personally. In fact, I know a lot, but there is some that when I mentioned that you're coming on the show before, they love you. They love your message. No, they love you, Kyla, because your message is creating strength in them. So you're not only empowering adults or humanity, especially to our youth, the challenge with everyday lives, just your story of resilience. And there was one that you shared, if you don't mind me saying, on Instagram, and you were just like this, and then you shared your story of what you were going through at that moment. And that really hit me. And as women, we need to see that, and we need to hear that and be reminded that we can go through it, right?
Yeah, definitely. I really want to, I found that in, you know, I've always wanted to share a message, not so that more people can understand what we're going through and relate. But I really want other people to be able to connect and not only understand our story, but hearing from other people that, you know, whether they message me or they connect with someone that I know, like through you, hearing those stories or their stories are healing for me and my family as well. Knowing that we're helping by sharing and advocating and sharing, that means a lot for our healing journey as well through this hard life, whether it be medical or non-medical. There's lots of hard things in everybody's life all the time. And I think helping each other out is really healing.
But you keep saying it, hon, you don't know how powerful you are to us. And I thank you from my heart. I just want to, we haven't got too much time, and I want to just grab your beautiful time, hon, is that you went to an event. It was some gala, and you were dressed to kill. Like, you had the makeup on, and we don't have pictures to show the viewers. Just go to her Instagram page, guys. You can dig it up and find it for her stories there and TikTok. But what event was that? Like, you look you're beautiful already, honey. But you look like you just came out of Hollywood.
I don't get very many chances to dress up. So I took that one. I was like, yeah, let's do it. But I was invited to a summer end social via a management team that I'm hoping to work with. And I reached out on my socials, and I'm like, okay, I have this event, and they had like an attire. I don't even know what you call it, but it's like, come dressed like this. And it was like fancy, and it was like important. And I really wanted to put myself out there for jobs. Yes. And so I was like, okay, I want to, you know, what is it like to go to a job interview? Because that's not anything that's been in my life lately. So I reached out on Instagram and just said, hey, anybody in Toronto that can help dress me, style me for this event? And I had amazing local companies reach out and be like, I'll do your hair, I'll do your makeup, I'll style you. And
wow,
I made friends through this experience. I met incredible people. They understood my story. And then they, you know, I even had the gentleman that styled my hair. He, you know, once he learned my story, he's like, you know,
wanted to do like free hairdos here, right?
Yeah. So he is a stylist, and
I like to do free like hair.
Yeah.
Here.
Yeah. Sorry, Bella's chiming in over there.
That's okay. That's okay.
He understands now what it's like for moms and dads to live at the Ronald McDonald House because their sick child is in hospital, and he wants to use his business to help other families that are far from home, you know, that sort of thing. And there's just really there's a lot of opportunity, but it was a really great event, and I was spoiled
a little bit. You should be spoiled, sweetheart. You should be spoiled. You reap what you sow. You always sow good, so you're reaping what you deserve, honey. And there's more to come. We only have a minute and a bit left, and I don't want to is there anything that you would like to share with our viewers before I let you go? Is there anything?
If whoever is listening out there, anytime you go through it, because I know those times are going to come up, they come on like heavy waves for me, please know that I don't know how else to say it other than I hope you feel me with you, and what I'm trying to portray online helps you and reach out to me. I'm pretty active in my DMs. And if you're going through it, I'd love to either pray for you or talk to you or interact with you in some way to help you out, because that matters to me too. I know our story is unique and I want to share it to help others and to put good into this world, because this world is hurting right now.
Yes. Yes. Big time. Yeah. You do it, honey. Look at you holding back your tears, sweetheart. Yeah. Those big, big eyes. Blinky, blinky. You can cry anytime you want, girl. Listen, you can cry. You know me. I'm real. So I'm going to let you go, honey, because I know you got a busy schedule and time. Will you come back?
Of course.
Awesome. So give me the heart. There you go. All right, honey. Love you a lot, sweetheart. Love ya.
Come say bye.
Bye.
Thanks, Joy.
You're welcome, sweetheart. Bye.